Good morning, guys.
Good morning, guys.
Can you hear me well?
Can you hear me well?
Should be better now, right?
Should be better now, right?
Every day I have to adjust the volume controls. It's so annoying. Every day. See? Okay. Great. I could hire someone to adjust my volume controls. Sounds like a full-time job. What's my view on the market today? I think it could go up, I think it could go down, or it could go sideways. Or it could go up first, then down, or down first, then up, or up first, then sideways, or down first, then sideways, or it may go sideways, then down, or sideways, then up, or it goes sideways, up and down, and then sideways, down and up. Or it may go sideways, down, and sideways. Or it may go sideways, up, and side. I mean, there's so many scenarios. I haven't really even thought about all of them. I just guess we have to adjust as these scenarios play out. Jokes aside, I think we bounced off support. The 100 day both in the SPYs and Qs, which is good, and now we're back in range. And the good thing is though, there are some things setting up. Some of these more speculative stocks have shown strength, relative strength, over the past few sessions. A lot of the like beaten down software names, etc., are building higher lows. And there are, you know, two setups I'm looking at are these cybersecurity names, Fortinet and PanW. Very interesting. Two that look good. There's other stocks too in that sector that look good. AA? Yeah. Yeah, this is a slow mover, but yeah, it can make a move. Yeah. Not many popular stocks above the 50-day moving average, but you also have to understand something. Rallies start when very few stocks are above the 50-day moving average, and rallies stop when a lot of stocks are above the 50-day moving average. So it's kind of a good thing that not a lot of stocks are above the 50-day. Doesn't really mean anything. It doesn't mean a rally has to start. We can go much lower. But generally, that is true. Yeah, S is another one. CrowdStrike. Yeah, they're kind of you know, they're kind of lower. Yeah, they've been building. I don't know, are these flags or bear flags? Not sure. Good luck, everyone. MongoDB is also one that looks pretty decent. Whoops. Oh. All right. Yeah, this SIMO is strong. Semiconductors is still a leading group. Semiconductors and cybersecurity. But I'm waiting for better setups in this, in the more liquid ones. Thank you. So Russell is stronger than Spice and Q's for now.
Well, looks like we are fading a little bit. Which is good, I think we need more base building. Base building is good. AMC, I think it would be good if it rallies into the 50 day, into the declining 50 day. I think that would be a good spot to maybe get into some kind of a short position, either maybe not shorting the stock, but maybe doing it in options or something a little bit longer term. This thing belongs sub $5. Maybe. It's going to 1 million, maybe it's going to 2 million. Little late for what then, MU? MU, yeah, it's getting close to the average daily volume. That's what you want to see. ON. Yeah, they look pretty similar, all of them. ON, KLAC. I mean, it look, yeah. There's several that look pretty decent. What's this rally?
Mm.
Well, reopening stocks are very strong. Airlines, cruise lines, hotels, Live Nation. Did I catch short on USD TRY? Yeah, I shorted the top and covered the bottom on size. I trade Forex all night. That's what I do when I don't stream. I trade Forex. Who's shorting my Pfizer? Who's shorting my Pfizer? Bastards. Kenny boy? Yeah. The guy who ruined Christmas. Do I look for high stock beta return on equity at least 17%? Yeah, my return on equity cutoff is 17.02%. No, I don't look at many other things. I look at the guidance. The most important thing is the price action and the volume. And overall momentum, obviously. Bill looks for at least 17%. Well, MU has exactly 17% in return on equity. What a lucky coincidence. Guess I'm good to go then. My take on augmented reality, it's up 4.35% on a day. be building higher lows. I mean, I guess it looks pretty decent. What's RRC doing? These nat gas stocks, right? Aren't they like nat gas names? What's the other? There's a few more. I don't remember the tickers right now. They look pretty good. They look pretty good. It looks actually pretty damn good. It's, look how nice it's surfing the 100 day, building higher lows. Now it's kind of trying to get out of this range. SMSD, yeah, yeah. Yeah, they're all strong. Well, all the oil gas related names are strong. EHR. Oh, it's a semi name. A lot of semi names. Dun, 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 dun. No, MU. MU is weak. Yeah, CRK is another one. Yeah, MP is one of these names that looks pretty damn good. Yeah, it's obviously wants to go higher. As soon as the market, you know, pressure lifts, it's gonna be 60, 70 bucks. I saw it on scan the other day. It's, yeah, it's surfing the 50, building higher lows. It really is strong. It's very, very strong. ARK is still strong. These stocks are definitely trying to bottom. Jumia, oh, that's a weak stock. Have I ever been an MGI? What the fuck is MGI? Man, I wonder if I shouldn't have shorted some Rivian on that pop. Oh, I could have gotten a perfect reshort on it. Damn. I dropped the ball on it. LAC failed earnings. I don't know what failed earnings means, but it's not trading on earnings, it's trading on future potential. You should read up on the company. Man, all these reopening names are up on the day. Casinos, resorts, cruise lines. Logitech. Yeah. Well, well. Not really a lot of things to do here. Not sure why this BFRI is going up. Except it broke up from this flag. Relentlessly higher lows. And then a gap up. Is there any news on it? Oh, it's just going 84% short interest? That's interesting. Is it true?
Eighty-5%.
Well, there are things developing. Definitely. There are things developing. Like, I really do like FTNT and PanW. And, you know, if they build more higher lows and get tighter, that would be even better. XBI. XBI looks could enter stage 2. This thing is a long way from stage 2. It's a long way from stage 2. I think you would be better off to actually find things that are already in stage 2. If you're into stage analysis. Four is weak. No, it's not. It's still building the base here. It's still inside of the range. The lower end of the range, but it's still range bound. It's trading exactly like the Qs. It's not strong, it's not weak. MU, I would say it's a 4-star EP. Could have been a bigger beat and stuff like that, and I'm not sure about the guidance. I didn't see any guidance. And the volume could be bigger. I would be happier if the volume was maybe like 30 million right now. It's barely above average. Almost an hour in, but it's fine. It's almost a mega cap stock. They usually don't have those crazy, crazy volume spikes. But yeah, I would say 4-star. LiDAR. Okay, so what are we looking at here? D dog. Yeah, yeah, it's another one. Isn't this also a cybersecurity name? Or am I wrong? I may be completely wrong, but yeah, it is strong. Cloud monitoring. You know what? Let's just say it's cybersecurity. So yeah, it's a very strong group. Application monitoring. So cybersecurity. HPQ. Oh yeah. Are they still in business? QSI. Damn, Tesla is weak. It's so much weak. Oh, okay, never mind. Nasdaq is also weak. I didn't see Nasdaq selling. Never mind. Damn, Tesla. Russell is holding though. SPYs and Qs are very weak, but Russell is holding. Interesting. The ARK stocks are holding too, or ARK for now. Because of AMC. AMC is like what, 1% of Russell? I don't think AMC is very relevant. What resources do you use? Look at, find chat rooms. I don't care about chat rooms. They're irrelevant to me. Yeah, I would hope so. Like, it would be great if it got a rally in these stocks that have generally been kind of beaten down and neglected over the past 8 months or so. like if we got some outperformance in those types of names versus these, you know, mega caps. But I still hope for like a real sell-off. Like it would be so good if we got another 10-15% decline in the major indices and get it over with. Really kill all the bullish sentiment. Blow out all those apes. And then get like a solid 6 month rally or whatever. Yeah, and get a new set of apes in. Well, MU is shaping up, building higher lows intraday. Looking decent. Ape together strong. Let's see. I'm not sure why I'm still looking at Rivian. I missed today's ad spot. Probably gonna regret it. Man, Tesla is so weak. So basically, you want an unanticipated global event to shock the markets. Yeah. This may come to a surprise to some, but it's always the unanticipated things that shock the markets. True story. It's never the anticipated things. It's always the unanticipated. So what you said is true. That's exactly what I want. I mean, nothing serious. I don't want like Omicron to kill 10% of the population or whatever. I just want, I don't know, Kenny Boy sell with a market order. And, you know, push the markets down 10-15%? Is it too much to ask for? Roblox is weak. Yeah, there's a lot of like potential bear flags. Like, I don't know, are these kind of a bottom information? So, like if I'm looking something like Melee, is this a bear flag or is it gonna go back to 1600? And CrowdStrike too, like what I like about CrowdStrike, it's right on the monthly 20, it's building a week of the 20 monthly. And you know, like if you look at the kind of flag here, that turned out to be a bull flag, right? The stock looked like shit and then it kind of had a big rally. No, same thing with Twilio, right? It looked like shit. Built higher lows, broke out, and had a big rally. Almost 70% in 2 months. And that one too was right. It looks exactly like CrowdStrike. Wicked off the 20 monthly. But the direction it breaks is gonna be the tell, right? If it goes lower, then it's a bear flag. If it goes higher, well, then it wasn't a bear flag. So you can't, you kind of have to wait for the direction. So I think it's a good thing if this thing goes sideways and tighten up a little bit. Do I have any Christmas plans? Yes. LAC, is LAC going lower? It's up. Damn it. Tesla. Well, it's a good thing. It's a big short position, but I wanted to add to it. I even had this trend line here, trend line alert. But I hesitated because it's already down so much on the day. But it's definitely showing a relative weakness. Like yesterday also, it showed relative weakness to the Nasdaq 100. Do you think Kenny has shorted his Christmas gifts? I don't know. Yeah, I agree. The term black swan is misused. It's always the things that no one is worried about that cause the big problems. That's the definition of the surprise or a shock. Am I long or short LAC? Yes. Mm-hmm. What's Snowflake doing? Building a base. Does my size on EPs differ a lot in this environment compared to more favorable? No, not really. Pfizer positive news. Well, the positive news I see on it is bouncing off the 65 EMA on the 60 minute. That's all the news I need to know. Merck, Pfizer and Merck COVID pills. Is that the positive news you're talking about? Who's Kenny? Kenny boy is Kenneth Griffin, aka the Grinch. The cringe is your boy. Dun da dun dun da dun. We need a new LEDs. What do you mean? Oh, yeah, I remember LEDs. I remember that one. That was funny. That was funny. Come on, MU. Take out the highs of the day already.
Dun, 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 dun.
Is JXN shit? It looks great. What kind of a question is that? It's obviously not shit. Do you want me to stroke your ego or something? I'm already using weekly setups to some extent. Have you gone back to any lockdowns in Sweden? We never had any lockdowns. Apps, I don't know. It's in a big range. I don't see anything special here. Did I trade AMR this year? No. It's incredibly thin stock. Why on Momo watchlist there are mainly cyclical names? Because many of them are leaders right now.
You like that, right? Can you say that softer and more slowly? No. I'm not gonna give you the satisfaction, you fucking perverts. Air gas? Oh my god. Alright, I don't really see much value here. Just, it's like watching paint dry. It's base building period. It's a base building period. There are definitely things setting up, but we're not really there yet. It's a patient. It's a patience game. All right, guys. See you tomorrow. Good luck.